Today is the first ever legal empowerment convening in Malawi, and it's also the beginning of the launch of the Mazika Legal Empowerment Network. The work that we're doing here today, the legal empowerment work, and including the launch of the Mazika Legal Empowerment Network, has been made possible through the funding support of OSISA. And we are also working with partners at MHUB and ActionAid Malawi, who are serving as a fiscal agent for the Gender and Justice Unit during this time. The network is targeting legal empowerment practitioners, that's why I like to say. They might not even know themselves in that sense, but they are doing the kind of work that brings access to justice closer, mainly to the poor, but also to people who are marginalized or are on the fringes. So we're creating a community, we are creating a joint strategizing platform, and also giving back to those members, sharing tools and resources across the membership base itself. If you get this message, all you need to do is sign up. Go to our website and go to the network page on our website, and you can sign up to join. When you do join, you will also be able to sign up to our mailing list, so you get information about private events, you will get information about updated tools that have been shared on the network, you will have access to a member directory, which will have details of other people who are on the network, people or organizations. You'll be a part of joint strategizing, you'll be a part of campaigns. If we are doing advocacy work, we'll be reaching out to members of the network to join in that advocacy work. Also, if we're applying for funding, we will look first to the network members to be partners in and collaborate in funding applications. One of the hugest challenges that we have in development work in this country, or maybe one or two of the challenges we have, one is that we don't take charge of the narrative. We're not speaking to development work from our own Global South perspective. We need to do that. We need to be the leaders of our own story. The other is that we work in silos. We're separated by the scuffle for development aid and for funding, and sometimes that separation, instead of making us stronger, it weakens us, because every time you're starting work from scratch, every single time it's like a new activity or a new project. But why not instead join together? And so when it's a legal empowerment related piece of work, so you're working on gender related laws, somebody in the network has already developed simplified and translated tools that you can draw upon and use. It makes us all stronger.
We are WOJAM, what we are called, Women Judges Association of Malawi. We are an NGO made up of female judges and magistrates, as well as male judges and magistrates. And the nature of our work is we kind of advocate on bringing the courts closer to the people, making them more relatable, more making them more accessible, and simplifying what happens in the courtroom. So our work requires that people actually bring cases to the courtroom. And so we hope that the members of the network identify cases that are needed, that need access to justice, that need redress in terms of violations of human rights, redress in terms of violations of legal issues, like whether you talk about matrimonial cases. We believe we all have different niches that we're working in, we all have different capacities, but by working together, we can achieve greater. And it's not greater for us, but it's greater for the people of Malawi.
Women's Legal Resources Center is a women's rights organization that helps women access justice, and we look at this from three angles, the legal part, and there's the social part, and also there's the economic part. We believe in partnership, so in this network, for us to come in and work with other members in the network, it will be a complementary work. As an organization, we have also gaps in other areas. So where there is a gap in skills, we'll be able to refer to one of the member in the network that has expertise in that area.
As the Women Lawyers Association, we are in a government organization that is offering free legal services to citizens in Malawi, and we do take up legal research as well as pro bono cases before the courts to ensure that justice is given to the people that are not able to afford the services of private lawyers. The Mazika Legal Empowerment Network is a network for all of us. All of us organizations that are working in the civil society in Malawi, and the advice that I would give is to encourage them to join in the network, to participate in the activities of the network, because in there we'll be sharing skills, knowledge and expertise, and also collaborating so that we do not work as individual organizations but as a group, so that we ensure that we achieve a greater outcome in terms of legal empowerment for the citizenry in Malawi.
Let's break the silos. Let's really, together we go farther.
So if you are out there and think you want to do great for this country, great for the people that live in this space, I'd definitely urge anybody who is in that space to join us in this network.
The setup of the network is timely. It's time that we needed a strong network that works on legal empowerment issues in Malawi. It is the first of its kind, and we are hopeful that in the year 2020, we'll be able to reach out to more areas through our collaboration that we have.
So go to the website, sign up.